van de platvijf van de zonde. Improvive, de Geek 5 en de LW. All three models share the same dampening system. Dampening on vibraphones mostly comes with issues. Issues like uneven dampening. One side of the instrument dampens more accurate than the other side of the instruments, or sharps dampening faster than naturals, or buzzing, or other excessive noise. On our instruments, we looked at why are the sharps dampening faster than the naturals. The reason is simple. On almost any vibraphone on the market, you'll find the dampener bar on the outside has those two pivot arms. And what happens? There's a dampening bar, there's the bar, a dampening bar. If you pull the pedal down, the dampening bar rotates in a circular way away from the bar. Then releasing the pedal, it comes back and it first touches the sharps. Then later it touches the natural. There are ways to compensate that by adding adjustments on the side, but as soon as you move the instrument, you have to readjust again. Or if you do something with the pedal, you have to readjust it again. We think that's not the way to solve this problem. What we've done is remove those pivot arms. What we do is our dampener bar is going perfectly straight. Like that, it's impossible that the sharps are dampened earlier than the natural bars. The other problem that occurs a lot is the uneven dampening. Now, uneven dampening is caused by only one thing, and that's the pedal. Most manufacturers add a small width pedal. A small width pedal is the worst part you can put on a vibraphone. What happens is, with a small width pedal, now the dampening system puts a lot of force onto the vibraphone. It pushes the whole instrument apart. If you add a small width pedal, you are forcing, or you are applying all the force to the center of the crossbar, to the center of the instrument, where the instrument is the weakest. On top of that, with a single width pedal, you will gonna use only one pulling rod or strap that you attach to your dampener bar, and only pull on one position the dampener bar down. Now, as soon as you move the pedal, the small width pedal, only slightly, you're gonna pull on the dampener bar at a different angle. And then it's inevitable, no matter what you do, it's inevitable that the dampener bar is gonna be pulled at an angle and released at an angle. So one side of the instrument always is dampening earlier than the other side. It doesn't matter if you use one spring or two springs. Even two springs makes it even worse. What you need to do is to use a wide pedal, like we do. A wide pedal. It's, you don't need to have the pedal swiveling. There's enough space for you to maneuver. There's always enough space to put your feet on. Doesn't matter where you push, it's always on all sides, the pedal moves perfectly horizontal. Also, we have enough space for two pulling rods. And two pulling rods is what you need. Two pulling rods is what you need to get to pull down your dampener bar. Two pulling rods also means two springs. We made the springs adjustable, but they're only adjustable for the feel of the pedals. Some prefer tight pedaling, some prefer light pedaling. Another big disadvantage of the single width pedal is that the pedal is causing back problems. Many vibraphone players complain about back problems and they all think it's because of the weight of the instrument. It's not true. It's only because of the posture they have to have when they play at the instrument with a small width pedal. What you need to do with a small width is you're gonna balance on one foot, and if you play high you have to maneuver and you have to change the posture of your body towards the instrument. Now, with a wide pedal you don't have that problem. You can use your left foot, you can use your right foot, wherever you are standing behind the instrument. Also, when you use a wide pedal, there are two parts where the pedal is connected to the crossbar, meaning you divide the force of the pedaling over more areas in the crossbar. That means the crossbar does not bend as easily. That means the instrument is much more stable, and which also means playing the instrument is more comfortable than with using a small width pedal. And big advantage is when you use a wide pedal, the pedal is always there. It's not like if you move your feet, you have to look down, okay, where's my pedal? It happens to me a lot when I play on the vibraphone with the small width pedal. I'm always lost, where's my pedal? The last thing that vibraphone players complain about is noise in the instrument. And the noise, and particularly the buzzing, is caused by the felt they're using. When we started building vibraphones 17 years ago, we invented the silicon damper pad. Now, many vibraphone players already know this pad and they use it on their instruments. We use it on all our instruments and we sell it as a separate item for other instruments. Most of the other brands can be equipped with this silicon pad. What happens is with the silicon pad, the actual dampening is not done by felt, but is done by the silicon. Felt has a tendency of dampening audible frequencies, higher frequencies, later than lower frequencies. Silicon is a kind of a massive liquid and it dampens all audible frequencies at the same time scale. And because of that, you don't have buzzing and you have a more even decay of dampening of the higher tones, the higher frequencies in the bar, and the lower frequencies. So it's a more natural decay. The other big advantage of the silicon is that it absorbs most of the energy that you apply to the bar. So if you hit the bar, most of the force of the stroke is absorbed by the silicon and is not transferred or transmitted to the rest of the instrument. So you have a much quieter instrument.